What's going on, guys? It's your boy Scrub here, back again with another video. Hope you guys are having a great day. I know I am. If you are, be sure to press the like button. Otherwise, no joke, no scam. I'll be sad. Yeah, that's right. You don't want me to have a frowny face, so if you could press the like button so that way YouTube actually puts this video and recommend it, I'd appreciate it. Anyways, guys, today I've got a chill story time. You know, I was reading your guys' comments on the last video, and a lot of you guys said you really miss when I would be, like, more chill. So, I went through my catalog, you know, I was thinking about stuff that's gone on in my life that I think I could make, entertaining without having to scream too much. And I remembered the time where, this girl's grandpa was seriously getting put in the back of an ambulance, and I was watching her film a TikTok, and she asked me to take a picture with it. Low-key, I guess some people are terrible. You know, your grandpa's getting loaded in the back of an ambulance. You might never see him again because old people are fragile and stuff, and you're like, hey, look, if my grandpa's gonna die either way, I might as well get some TikTok clout out of it. And yeah, it should be a fun video. Hopefully you guys enjoy it, and without further ado, let's get into it. So a little bit of a backstory. Last summer, my parents threw like this family get together thing where basically, you know, everyone and their mom came over to my parents' house, and we had like a barbecue in the backyard. All my aunts, all my uncles, all my cousins, everybody's gone to the family party. You know, your uncle gets too drunk, makes inappropriate comments. All been there, done that. And at this family party, I was talking to my mom about what's going on because I hadn't seen her in like a week or two. And she's telling me, you know, that my cousins are enjoying like their new house in the neighborhood. My family's super whack. Basically, everybody but me lives within like 3 blocks of each other. My aunt, my uncle, my grandma, and my mom and dad all live within like 2 streets of it. And my aunt had just moved there with like 3 of my cousins. And she's talking to me about how my aunt, you know, has this super sweet neighbor at the end of the street who's super great to the kids and is, you know, very helpful and super nice to the neighborhood. And my mom has like talked about this old dude that lives near my aunt and grandma before and how he's super nice. And this is a really old dude, okay? I don't want to insult elderly people because I honestly think old people are awesome because they just don't have to care. Old people are allowed to be rude. Old people are allowed to insult people, and there's nothing you can do about it because you're old. And because of that, I just think old people are funny. And this dude is pretty old. He's so old, I wouldn't be surprised if he sat behind Jesus in the 3rd grade. You know, he's so old, he kind of looks like Emperor Palpatine from Star Wars with the amount of wrinkles he has. And that's not really an insult. He's a super nice dude. I'm just telling you guys that this was a really, really old man. But regardless, he's super nice to my aunt and my cousin. And then my mom, you know, gets close and does that, like, hush tone that all the moms do when they're about to drop the hottest gossip on the street, you know? And my mom is a little bit of a gossip, all right? I love her till the end of time, but she has a little bit of a problem with, talking about other people's business a little bit. And she starts telling me that the super old man that lives near my aunt and grandma, and also his house is visible from my parents' house. It is so weird that my family all lives so close together. Like, I love my family a ton, but I need at least 2 neighborhoods of distance between me and my family, you know? I gotta keep it fresh. I don't want my aunt, like, dropping in the middle of the day while I'm cooking pancakes naked or anything. She starts telling me that this 85-year-old man that looks like he sat behind Jesus in the 3rd grade has taken in his granddaughter, and she's a train wreck. My cousins are like the same age as her, or at least one of them is. I have one cousin who's 15 and one who's 17, and this girl is 16. And they're telling me that she's always in trouble, she's always skipping school, but because her grandpa is, you know, older than Franklin the Turtle, he doesn't really know much about it. Like, it's pretty easy to get away with a bunch of easy crimes. Not even crimes, that's too strong of a word. It's really easy to get away with stuff when your grandpa is so old that, like, even if you sneak out, shaking a can and a Macarena at the same time, making as much noise as humanly possible, his old deaf ears won't hear you. So it's pretty easy to get up to mischief most of the time when your grandpa can't stop you even if he wanted to. And now his granddaughter is always causing all these problems. And to be honest, I looked at my mom and I'm like, yeah, that's crazy, but I'm gonna go play football with my cousins now. Basically any excuse to get away from the gossip, dude, because my aunt walked over. And when 2 moms start talking about like neighborhood gossip, it's just never gonna end. And I'm not trying to spend 7 hours listening to my aunt and mom talk about my neighbors. So I go outside with my cousin, who, like I said, 17, 15, and we just start throwing the football around, playing catch, catching up. How's school going? How's YouTube going? The normal convo. And like I said, from my house, like, around, or not my house, my parents' house that I grew up in, like, around the corner, you can see this old dude's house. And as we're playing football, an ambulance comes tearing down our street, turns the corner, and starts going to the old dude's house. And like I said, he's been super nice to my aunt and my cousins, so my cousins are obviously like, oh my god, what do we do? And I'm like, all right, well, let's go down there and see if they need anything, like, see if there's anything we can do. And I obviously don't think there's much I can do to help paramedics. I'm not trained in anything, but, like, I didn't know what to do. What are you supposed to do? I didn't know what to do. So I probably made the wrong choice. People in the comments right now are probably like, oh my God, why would you go see if they needed anything? My bad for, like, trying to do the right thing, all right? Most of you guys would have been like, oh, that's crazy. I'd gone back inside and played Fortnite. At least I was trying to do something, you know? But yeah, I probably looked like an absolute clown. So we walk down there and we realize that they're not gonna need our help very quickly because we're a bunch of idiots and they are trained paramedics that are, you know, taught for years how to deal with situations like this. So obviously they don't need any help from people as dumb as us. But whatever, we're standing down there and the paramedics go in the house, and about 10 minutes later, out comes this old man on a stretcher. You know, he's got an oxygen mask on his face and he does not look conscious. It's not looking very good. You know, he's an old man, like I said, 85, and when 85-year-olds go unconscious and the ambulance has to come respond to them, it's usually not a good sign. As I learned in The Lion King, the circle of life is fragile, and it looks like this dude is not in the good part of the circle of life. So me and my cousins are standing there in absolute silence because I just watched an old man that looks like he's on the verge of death get taken out of his house. So I'm obviously not doing too hot. The guy's not doing better. My cousin, my little cousin who's 15, is crying because this old man is like the only person that's been nice to them in their new neighborhood, and he's watching him get carted out. So obviously we're just like sitting there in silence, you know, because I'm not an expert on what to do in this situation. I'm just like frozen up like an idiot because I'm just dumb, I guess. And as we're sitting there watching this old man get loaded into the back of an ambulance, out comes this guy's granddaughter, who, you know, 16 years old, probably, if I had to guess. I didn't, like, ask for her school ID after this. Excuse me, ma'am. I'm going to be making a YouTube video about how bad of a person it appears that you are. Can you please do me a favor and let me see your school ID so I can verify your age? Like, that probably wouldn't go over well. And she comes out, phone in her hand, and as she's walking by us to, like, get a video of her grandpa getting put in the back of an ambulance, I hear a song and I look and she's making a TikTok. And guys, this is how bad it is. As she's filming this TikTok, my brain is like a little bit delayed picking things up because obviously, you know, when you're watching people get loaded in an ambulance, you kind of don't pay attention to most surroundings. She is making a TikTok to the Charlie Puth song, See You Again with Wiz Khalifa, the song that they play after Paul Walker died in The Fast and Furious. This girl's grandpa definitely like just had a seizure or something, is getting loaded into the back of an ambulance, and she is making a TikTok with the song See You Again. Like, if that's your first thought, yeah, grandma's in the hospital, man. If we want any juicy TikTok clout, we better get to the hospital quick. They said she has 2 hours left. That means that if we each make 15 TikToks, we have enough content to spread it out and post it for simp. So obviously, this girl is like TikToking her grandpa getting loaded in the back of the ambulance, right? And I'm just sitting here flabbergasted at this girl just really being willing to TikTok her grandpa right before he gets loaded in the back of an ambulance. So she finishes her TikTok and turns around and sees me and my cousin standing there, and she walks up to us and goes, oh, where are you guys from? So I explain, like, oh, I used to live here, like, my parents are, and I say their name, and she's like, oh, okay. And she obviously recognizes my cousins, and she's like, hey, will you take a picture with me in the ambulance? And I go, oh, yeah, for, like, insurance? And she goes, no, I just want something to post on Instagram to let people know that my grandpa's in the hospital. And I'm like, and she hands me her phone, goes over to the ambulance, and does the pose. You know the pose where, like, girls stick their back out to make their butt look bigger? Like, this girl is trying to thirst trap next to the ambulance that is holding her grandpa. So I just am like holding the phone, and she's like, are you gonna take the picture? And my cousin takes it out of my hand, takes a couple pictures and gives it to her. She looks and goes, no, I don't like these, take more, and is making us take more pictures. So at this point, the old man's all loaded in and he's like, all right, well, he's not like, all right, the paramedics say, are any of you related to him? You know, are you family? And obviously, I'm not his family. Me and my cousins say no. The granddaughter goes, oh, I'm his granddaughter. And they're like, okay, do you want to ride with us in the ambulance to the hospital? And she goes, what hospital? And they tell her, and she goes, no, it's okay. And the paramedic's kind of like, oh, all right, that's not the response I'm used to relatives giving when their relatives are going to the hospital, but okay. And the ambulance leaves to take him to the hospital. So after the ambulance leaves, I look at the girl, I'm like, oh, do you need a ride to the hospital? I mean, it's weird you turn down the ambulance, but like, you're not thinking right, you know, your grandpa just went to the hospital, you're probably just, I don't know, not thinking, I guess. And she looks and goes, oh no, I'm not gonna go visit him in the hospital, that's gross, and went back inside. And I'm like, What? Oh, no, my grandpa who took me in because, I don't know, and is raising me out of the kindness of his heart that he doesn't have to do, that which went to the hospital after being sure to take care of me all the time. Yeah, I'm not gonna visit him because hospitals are gross. So after that terrible interaction, bro, we go back to my family party and we're telling my mom and my aunt, and they're like, see, I told you, see, it's just nothing but trouble. And, you know, it was just a very uncomfortable situation, I'm not gonna lie. I just can't, like, I love my grandma, dude. My grandma is the greatest person to ever exist. If she was ever in the hospital, bro, I would sprint there faster than Usain Bolt in the Olympics. I wouldn't be like, hey, can you guys take a picture of me with my butt hanging out for Instagram next to this ambulance? Oh, I'm not gonna go visit my grandma in the hospital. That's disgusting. Like, I guess some people are just bad. Low-key, I hope her TikTok popped off, though, because the comment section would probably be like, why are you filming your grandma getting put in the back, or grandpa, excuse me, I was still thinking about my lovely grandma. Why are you thinking about your grandpa getting put in the back of an ambulance and your first thought is to just whip out the TikTok? I guess that's just some people, though. Like, some people are just bad people, there's no saving it. But on that note, guys, that's gonna do it for the video. I know the story time was a little more chill, alright? Like, I'm not really sure what I'm gonna title it, don't really know if the clickbait is really there. But regardless, I enjoyed making this video, you know? Nice chill vibes. If you guys have any other advice, you know, anything you want to see, let me know. Turn on those notifications, and yeah, today's notification shout out goes to the very swagtastic Exotic Bell. Big thank you for having on notifications. I really appreciate it. If you want a notification shout out, turn on the noties, send a screenshot to my Instagram at Scrubby. Check out the merch, follow me on Twitter, and don't get anyone pregnant. If you do, make sure they're hot. I beat Bumpkin in a 1v1. That's what matters. I'm out. Peace.